check it. Seems like yesterday. Most people know this song. It's Puff Daddy's touching tribute to the late, great Notorious B.I.G. But not everybody knows who wrote the lyrics. I write my own with bigger hope, trigger scope,
wrote what I figure, no. Damn, you dig a nigga dope. Sauce motherfucker. Family, let's go, bro.
This is Sauce Money. He wrote Diddy's verses on the Grammy Award winning I'll Be Missing You.
Everybody knows that Puff isn't a writer.
Don't worry if I write rhymes, I write checks.
So originally, he had reached out to your guy, Jay-Z. I apologize, ladies, I'm loving your ride. You must be used to me tricking, but we fucking a nine. No wine, no dime, no willing to win. All night long, just feeling the dick. So yeah, and Jay and Big had a really close relationship.
Yeah, they were pretty tight. Jay-Z, Big Smalls, nigga, shit your drawers. Brooklyn represent y'all, hit your falls. It could be difficult at that time to open up and try to eulogize a good friend. For whatever reason, he reached out to me and said, you know, listen, I'm gonna introduce you to Puff. I remember going to the studio, sitting down with him. I didn't know which record it was at the time. He started explaining what it was, and I'm, you know, just off the initial conversation, I'm just blown away, like, wow.
Hov couldn't even give you a heads up. He just sent you into that room.
Yeah, he just, you know, but, you know, thank you. I mean, it's bittersweet.
He was only 24 years old, was just starting what was expected to be a promising career in music, but tonight, it's only what could have been.
I'm still affected by Big's death, but, you know, like, wow, to have a chance to, you know, participate in something like this, it was an honor.
You're not technically a ghostwriter on this record, per se, because you received writing credits. Your name appears on the credit,
right? Right.
What's that initial conversation like? I'm sure Puff, while emotional, has things that he wants to express.
He just wanted to capture some of the things that they did. Seems like yesterday we used to rock the show. I laced the track, you locked the flow. Some of the conversations that they had. Even though you're gone, we still a team. You know, make it as visual as possible. In the future, can't wait to see if you open up the gates for me. It was kind of easy for me because through Missing You, I still kind of was talking to my mother, because not too long before that, I had lost my mother. Anybody that's ever lost their mother still knows, you know, you still reel from that every day to the day. So it was kind of easy for me to jump into that character. Mm-hmm. It didn't take long.
Right.
You know, the record, probably, we did the record on my part probably about 15, 20 minutes, maybe half hour. Right. Once I did it, I referenced it. You know, he heard it, that's it. You know, I made sure I stayed with him. I made sure that I walked him through it just to make sure he got as close to the rhythms and all that as he could or whatever. And I mean, he did a great job.
And then the record, I mean, obviously has the Sting sample in it. We bring Faith Evans. We bring 112 into it. When you're actually writing to the track, which parts of the track are present?
When I got it, it was, I think the hook might have already been on it. Once the hook is on it, forget it. It's the duck walk from that point.
This very much sounds like Puff. Normally, I mean, your lyrical stack, metaphors, similes layered up. 100,000 running wild cats who dig rapping, pimp slapping rappers the fuck backwards like pig Latin. I feel like if you were writing this record as Sauce Money for yourself, you might have approached it.
Yeah, there's certain things that I may be able to pull off lyrically that I wouldn't even try with certain people. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not gonna sound authentic or genuine. So it's money till the day I lay. So true, Big and Jay love the dough, and I love the dough too. Baby. The key to anybody quote unquote ghostwriting is to step out of your character to become that person. Mm-hmm. To say all the things that person that you think that person might say without leaving any fingerprints or traces of you.
There's still bars in here. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Yeah. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death. The fact that we're sitting here talking about it today just proves like he'll never die. As a brother, I'm looking at it like, I'd do anything to bring you back, man. You know what I'm saying? So, but even though I know I can't, I know you still living in heaven, you know what I'm saying? And your memory is always gonna be cemented out here in music, right, and in life, period.
Right. And the last thing that B.I.G. left us with before he left us with a body of work, life after death. What about Us in the Six shopping for new clothes and kicks? You and me taking flicks.
Us in the Six shopping for new clothes and kicks. You and me taking flicks.
Big, if you knew Big, Big always rapped about the 600 Benz. You know.
Six, yo.
Lyrically, I'm untouchable, uncrushable, getting mad blunted in the 600 Benz.
We sat down, me and Puff, and we had conversation. You know, and you know, I got to know a little bit about him and some of the things he might like and, you know, some of his visions. And, you know, you just try to incorporate it and mix it up and just make a nice gumbo.
And he performed it at for the VMAs in New York.
Yeah.
When you're in the studio writing and collaborating on this record, do you see legendary VMA performance happening in your head? Do you see Grammys? Like, do you envision all of this, or does your mind not even process that at this point?
Nah, not at that particular point in my life or my career. Like, now I could say, like, well, that has a possibility to do, you know what I'm saying? But at that point, no, I didn't hear that. I was too green.
19 years later, we're still talking about that.
Anything that's classic, mm-hmm, whether it be Adidas,
right,
Shell Toes,
right,
or Air Force Ones,
right,
or Jordans, you know what I'm saying, the threes. Mm-hmm. Like, it doesn't matter. Like, 20 years later, they're gonna still have the same impact. A classic is classic. Classic music, you can hear it 20 years later, and it'd be like, wow, this could be a hit right now.
Right.
Because, you know, it's just timeless.